Hi, I'm Annie from the Maison Blanche Paint Company, and today I'm going to show you how to transform your furniture with an easy and elegant crackle finish. I found this table at the resale store. It's beautiful. She was a little dusty and she was holding the finer shoes. I really wanted those velvet crocodile boots, but they were one size too big. So I came home with her, she was 20 bucks, and I set to work. The first thing that I did was I made sure that it was completely free of dust, grit, and grime. Clean your furniture piece really well. Then I painted her with Maison Blanche Vintage Furniture Paint in Oyster. I'm gonna use this board to show you what I did next. This is a Maison Blanche B stencil. It comes in a package with two other really cute stencils, a number 7 and a crown. This is the B we're gonna use today, and a little stencil adhesive. I'm gonna gently set this on the surface. I'm just gonna eyeball it. Next, I'm gonna use Maison Blanche Paint Company Glissage in Walnut. Glissage is French, it means frosting. It's a nice thick consistency. This actually looks a little bit like chocolate frosting. I've got a room key, and I'm gonna use that to spread the glissage just onto my stenciled area. I'm going to hold it at a low angle, about 10 degrees, and just gently spread it on. Now, while the glissage is still wet, I'm going to lift off the stencil. And there's my B. I'm going to let this dry completely. My B is completely dry. Now I'm going to paint over it with a second coat of Maison Blanche Vintage Furniture Paint in Oyster. I'm using a roller. I just want to make sure that that bee is completely painted. Now I'm going to let it dry. My paint is dry. Now we're going to use a product called Le Crack. It's a crackle medium that comes in extreme or regular. Today we're going to use the regular. I've got some poured into a pan ready to roll. Now the important thing to remember with Le Crack is that if you want random cracking, then you want to roll in every different direction. Now I'm going to let the Le Crack dry and then apply a second coat of Le Crack for even more cracking. Now I'm going to put on another coat of Oyster paint. When I apply this coat of Oyster, I want to make sure that I go in the same random pattern that I applied the Le Crack in so I get those random cracks. Now the fun begins. It'll start to crack right before your eyes. My paint has dried and cracked nicely. Look at all that nice random cracking. I really love it. Now we're going to make the bee stand out a little bit more. I've got my bee stencil again. Adhesive one more time. I'm going to place it just on top of where I had it before. Now I'm going to use Maison Blanche Vintage Furniture Paint in Robin's Egg. This is a nice little 4-ounce sample jar for small projects. I've got a napkin and a chip brush. I'm just going to dab a little bit on and then swirl it into my B. There. I don't want it to be completely covered. I like kind of a little bit of the base or background coming through, so it's not complete coverage, but you could always do complete coverage if you wanted to. Now I'm going to remove the stencil. And here's my beautiful bee. It's nice and raised, and that blue really makes it pop. You can seal this surface with varnish or wax. For this table, we used our satin varnish. Today we used Maison Blanche Vintage Furniture Paint in Oyster. We used Glissage in Walnut. We used our Le Crack. our robin's egg vintage furniture paint, and we finished with our satin varnish. And let's not forget the signature Maison Blanche bee stencil. I love the way my table turned out. What a transformation. I'm actually going to use it in my bedroom at my house. We used a different stencil as well on this table. It's a Maison Blanche vintage laurel wreath stencil. Look how beautiful she is now. Thank you so much for watching our video. We've got more. Check them out and let us know what you think. We'd love it if you would take photos of your own completed projects and share them on the Maison Blanche Facebook page. Check us out at maisonblanchepaint.com. I'm Annie, and I'll see you next time.